Listen to this place.
Oh, big shot by McGregor.
10 seconds.
Oh, he's hurt.
Could he finish him here? It's all over. Conor McGregor is a UFC interim featherweight champion.
Wow.
This now sets up a fight with Jose Aldo that will be easily the biggest fight in the history of the UFC. Give me your thoughts on that.
In my eyes, Jose's gone running. If he wants to come back, he can come back, but I swear to God, his day will come.
Conor McGregor, ladies and gentlemen.
UFC 194, Aldo versus McGregor.
Now, what does Mystic Mac have to say about 2016?
The end of 2015 means the end of the featherweight division. If the Brazilian shows up, he's the so-called pound-for-pound number one, but he's quaking in his boots over there. But if he shows up December 12th, the division will be killed, like I predicted, and then it's on to the 155 stuck-in-the-mud division. After that five-round Mendez fight, you look like you've had a stroke. The left side of your face is drooping. Honestly, I'm worried. I love you like my bitch.
They're going to square off here right now. Jose Aldo has to catch a plane.
I don't know whether he'll be back. All I know is that I will be there December 12th, like I always am there. People are always saying about the talk, and I talk, and I talk, and I talk, but guess fucking what? I back it up.
Have you just got a hunch that he just doesn't want to face you?
Yeah. I feel him overreacting, overextending, and then being KO'd unconscious.
Lógico, comemorar como eu sempre fiz depois das lutas. E ele vai chorar em casa.
Your legacy, your career is done. I wish him a safe training camp and let's do this fight.
Ele passa na frente. Esmagá-lo.
He didn't show up the last time.
Vou matar esse filho da puta, vou arrancar a cabeça dele. Vai se arrepender.
He's gonna break.
Só tá o bicho em cima dele.
The world will be watching this fight.
I am in a state of Zen right now. My mind is calm, composed. I am prepared and ready to put on the performance of my life.
The pound for pound number one, undefeated 10 years, the only featherweight champion. What can they say now? What can they say after Jose falls?
Aldo!
McGregor. It's time to fight.
This is the main event of the evening.
Anticipated featherweight fight of all time. Hunter looks extremely loose, and Aldo looks like he's feeling the pressure of this moment. Here we go! Green trunks for the southpaw, the notorious Conor McGregor. Black trunks for the champion, Jose Aldo Jr.
Conor relaxed and smiling.
And he's fast, but precision beats power and timing beats speed, and that's what you saw there. That's all it takes. These are 4 ounce gloves. That's all it takes, and especially when you add my left hand. Nobody can take that left hand shot.
Just wow. No controversy, no confusion, clean. Congratulations, sir. You are the undisputed UFC featherweight champion of the world. You did it all, sir. Congratulations.
I didn't know you did it.
Conor, how do you feel right now?
I feel clean. I feel like my work has paid off.
Well, you just emphatically took out one of the greatest fighters of all time. You go into the UFC record books with the fastest knockout in UFC championship history.
Like I said before, and I've said many times, it's not the same when you sign to fight me. It's a whole other ball game. It's a completely different pressure bubble you're under. My respect, Jose. I wish him well. But now we are on to the next chapter.
What can they say now?
You know, there's always something. Yeah. There's always something, but questions are good. Like options are good. In the fight business, questions and options. I'm happy that there's both.
The division needs me. I don't need the division, so.
Dana said if you want that lightweight title fight, you know, if you go up, you could have it.
Most certainly, I'm looking to replicate what I have achieved in my previous promotion, a two-weight world champion, held consecutively.
It's a lot of pressure.
It's a fantastic performance.
Oh, there'll be a belt on one shoulder and a belt on the other shoulder. I said I would do it, and I will do it. I'm going straight up.
You mentioned Conor McGregor, and of course there was a big press conference where you exchanged a few words. He said he would change your.
Come, like, you fight me, it's a celebration.
I would beat you.
When you sign to fight me, it's a celebration. You ring back home. You ring your wife, baby. We done it. Break out the red panties.
My focus is on Cerrone. If UFC want to make this fight happen, I will have to welcome him.
Rafael Dos Anjos and Cerrone for the UFC Lightweight Championship. Yes,
hard body kick by Dos Anjos.
Mr. McGregor, if you want to come to lightweight division, this is my division, man. It's better to stay on featherweight division. I would fight you in Brazil. I would go to Ireland and face you there. Wherever you want, man. I'm here to stay.
The champion, ladies and gentlemen, Rafael Dos Anjos.
If you want to move up, I'm here. Gonna be easy money.
Champ Rafael Dos Anjos will take on Conor McGregor, moving up from 145-pound division. Never been done. Nobody's ever held two belts at the same time here in the UFC.
You know I get the kilos. Cinquenta per ciento.
I chose this one because this man across from me has a title. He is a free TV fighter. He has nothing else to offer me except that gold belt.
I believe inside 1 minute I will dust him, I will exit the contest fresh, I will cash the check, I will sign the next contract for UFC 200, a brand new MGM. We'll go again.
I'm gonna make him bleed. No, he gonna pay for all the respect this guy has. I'll send this guy back home and I'm gonna keep my belt.
I'm dressed like El Chapo in his prime. I'm running this company like half a wise guy. I am a multicultured individual. I am in here doing whatever I want.
Has no respect for anybody. He will feel what a single tool on Jesus' hands can do with him.
I'm cool with all the gods. Gods recognize gods. I am the god. I am in a league of my own here. Not one single individual in this company is on my level.
Conor McGregor was scheduled to fight lightweight champion Rafael Dos Anjos March 5th in Vegas until Dos Anjos withdrew from the bout this morning with a foot injury. But the line to fight McGregor, the reigning featherweight champion, is a long one. And joining us now with breaking news, Dana White. All right, Dana, the show will go on. So who is McGregor going to fight?
A lot of guys wanted this fight, but we ended up with Nate Diaz. We felt this was the fight to make and the fight that the fans wanted to see.
That's the kind of shit I'm talking about, man. We could do that shit tonight.
Is there going to be an interim lightweight title on the line?
This fight between him and Nate Diaz will be at 170 pounds. It will be a welterweight fight.
He's still in way better shape than most people, but he's a big 155er.
That Stockton slap. Wow.
Nate's got a nasty ground game, man.
He's a bad motherfucker, dude.
In real trouble. Oh, he might be out on his feet.
He's got it built off of me, you, and you.
Johnson.
Diaz.
Here we go. Mass combination by Nate Diaz.
This is the best Nate has ever looked. It really is.
This is a beautiful performance. How do you feel about it?
Fuck that. Conor McGregor, you're taking everything I work for, motherfucker. I'm gonna fight your fucking ass. You know what's the real fight? What's the real money fight? It's me, not these clowns that you already punked at the press conference. Don't no one want to see that. You know you beat them already. That's the easy fight. You want that real shit right here. Hey, and I'm not...
Unfortunately, we can't talk like that on Fox. Congratulations, man.
I got a phone call. Hey, guess what? Another guy's out. We have a couple other guys that maybe might be able to get in. Nate, for me, was the lead-in option. There were many, many options, but let's see what this man is about. He talked like I took something from him. That's what he said after the fight. And then everyone else went running. So, Nate, congratulations. You're rich now.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Bell. I don't give a fuck what you say, motherfucker.
Don't get me wrong. There's a respect there between us. But it's business in there. And business is business. He will be KO'd inside the fourth round.
I don't give a fuck.
I don't give a fuck either. I don't give a fuck either.
You know, most people, when they get that red panty night on me, they ring home to their wife. Baby, we did it. Nate rings Nick. Baby, we did it.
Nate, do you have a particular strategy?
Yeah, I'm just going to kill or be killed. That's what I'm coming with.
They want you to give us a quick count to 10, both of you, gentlemen.
Nate can only count to 5.
Dana White already said that you might be the best there is at mental warfare.
I'm certainly going to toy with the young boy. I'm going to play with him.
Take a coffee break, Nate. And by coffee break, I mean bring me my coffee.
Saturday night, I will eat his carcass in front of his little gazelle friends, and they can do absolutely nothing.
I could buy and sell you 100 times over. Now, about that coffee.
You're going to do jack shit.
I'm just the best there is, and that's it.
You really should be thankful and be grateful for this opportunity that I am giving him.
You're an imitator. That's what you are. I'm an innovator.
Yeah.
Great shit.
Connor, did you change your approach?
The only approach I changed is I dug the grave a little bit wider, a little bit longer for Nate's skinny, fat, long body. That's the only difference I made.
He don't believe his prediction. Better step it up for this one.
I'll gut you like a fish.
You were born rich.
You don't know me. You don't know where the I came from.
He has a bully mentality until a real man shows up.
Who do you train with? My whole team will fucking beat your whole team's ass. How about that?
Bring your training partners in. You're gonna need them.
Well, you know this is the real
deal. See, you know.
You know that.
You know it's the real and you'll know Saturday night.
You'll do fucking nothing.
The main thing to succeed in this game is to either be me or fight me. Everything else is peanuts.
Once again, we are live from Las Vegas inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena. We welcome you to UFC 196. McGregor versus Diaz. Sponsored by EA Sports UFC 2. McGregor never backs away from a fight.
Nate Diaz, in my opinion, is going to be the most difficult test of Conor McGregor's career. He's not going to get shaken, he's not going to get rattled, he's not going to get dwarfed by the moment. And Joe on 11 days notice.
Protect yourself at all times.
Whatever you want to do.
Follow my instructions. Touch gloves if you wish. Let's do this.
Not a chance. Nate Diaz, Conor McGregor. Here we go.
Southpaw against southpaw. Conor's movement is so brilliant.
Here's a nice left hand by Conor.
Conor the aggressor here early. Good head movement.
by McGregor.
And there's another one.
Connor's busting Nate up. Keep an eye on the cut, the right eye of Diaz.
Good left hand by Connor. Missed. Another good left hand by Connor. That one landed clean.
Some blood on the right side of the face of Nate Diaz. 15 straight wins for Conor McGregor. Round one in the books. Crowd loving it, justifiably so. Round two.
A lot of blood coming out of that right eye.
Good movement by Stockton's own.
Strong jab by Nate. Couple good right hands there by Nate Diaz.
Oh, he tagged him. Got him with the good one there. He hurt him with that left. And he senses it.
He's hurting him.
Taking it to McGregor here. Could he do it?
He's
on top. Trying to get out of it.
Connor's in serious trouble.
My goodness. Now he's got the back.
Flattened out. That's it. He's got the chance.
Nate Diaz.
He's out.
He has done it.
Gentlemen, what a night!
Playing the winner by submission, Nate Diaz!
You just shook up the world. How's that feel?
Hey, I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
They're the new king of this motherfucker now, and it's right here, all right?
It's a bitter pill to swallow. I took a shot, I went at it. I know there's a lot of people celebrating this.
And all of a sudden he's shooting for a takedown, yeah. And I'm like, oh, you're a wrestler.
Nothing surprised me, except for that I got hit at all. I think with a full camp, I would have been flawless.
In a perfect world, what would you like to do next?
This is the game. We win some, we lose some. I will never shy away from a challenge. I will never shy away from defeat. This is the fight business. It's another day. I'll come back.
No, I knew I was the superior boxer, the superior martial artist. I had the best training partners in the world in every aspect. If you ain't taking me out, you're gonna get taken out, straight up.
Nate, where do you go from here? What would you like to do next?
I'm at the top, so it's their call, what's next? We'll see what happens.
We are joined by the one and only Nate Diaz.
You're getting a lot of credit for this Conor McGregor win, obviously.
All of a sudden, Nate is a
superstar, dude.
God, I'm watching this Nate McGregor fight.
It was awesome. It was awesome.
I'm a hardcore fan. I've never enjoyed a fight more than I enjoyed Nate Diaz, Conor McGregor.
Who do you want to fight next? The little Irish guy?
Not to already throw you back in there, but will there be a rematch?
You said if McGregor wants a rematch and if the UFC wants a rematch, bring it on.
You gotta put him in against Nate again, because that's the big money rematch.
I just wanna get paid. So
people do want to see this fight again, and I'm one of those guys that I wanna make the fight that the people wanna see.
He was winning the fight, mm-hmm. And then Nate turns it around.
Man, he was lighting Nate up, cutting them all up.
I can't believe he lost.
I thought it was over for Nate. I really did.
MMA is very unpredictable.
Everybody wants to know, have you talked to him recently?
He's obsessed with this Nate Diaz fight. I don't know if I can get it done. I've been working on it.
Conor wanted to just run it back, and it's like, wow. That's interesting.
I'll be waiting for the rematch.
No matter what happened in that fight, his next fight, whoever he's fighting, he's gonna get fucked up.
How did this rematch come about, Dana?
He was obsessed with fighting Nate Diaz again. He wants to fight at 170. Even his coach tried to get him to get off this rematch and off the 170-pound fight, but it's what he wanted. He wants this Nate Diaz fight. We'll give it to him.
We can either run from adversity or we can face our adversity head on and conquer it. And that's what I plan to do.
Let's do it again. Nate was obviously up for the fight.
No question about it. And that's what fans wanted, and they will get it.
I think stylistically, it's a troublesome fight for him.
I don't think Conor wants that fight as much as he says he does.
Is he making a mistake going right back to you?
What can he possibly say at this point to talk smack to you?
He could have the same result the exact same way.
August 20th is my date, UFC 202, and I will have my redemption.
Conor got his ass beat.
This time, I'm going to be a lot more prepared for the size and the weight, and I'm going to tee off on him. This is the one. This is where I put everything to rest.
What's up, everybody? Thanks for coming today. We appreciate it. UFC 202 takes place Saturday, August 20th. We're starting without him. Yes, start respecting people's time, man. Yours, theirs, mine, theirs, everybody's.
They're making excuses for whatever. I don't know how all of a sudden became this monstrous heavyweight against Conor McGregor.
This guy want to fight. Got pictures
of me up in his garage with him punching me in the face. Like, what the fuck? Who does it?
Look, I'm just happy to be here. I'm ready to fight. That's all I know. Cut all the bullshit. I'm here. I'm ready to fight. Make no mistake, it will be a trilogy fight down the line. It won't be straight away, but we will do it 3 times, 100%.
Hey, fuck your whole team. How about that?
Fuck your whole team. Little crackhead SS. You'll do nothing. Shut your fucking mouth. You'll do nothing. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. Fuck you.
That's all right. Hey, Conor. Conor, don't throw those fucking hands. Conor. Conor. That's a wrap. Get him out of here.
Come on. I'm going back over here. Let me talk.
Sorry, guys. See you Saturday.
I'm going to kill you, man. See you. I'm going to blade and bullshit, man. Yeah, it's fucking... Fuck all that. Seriously, it's... Seriously, it's on now.
I walked in like he was the show, you know? But when I left, the show was over, so who's the show?
Conor, so how do you describe what happened during today's news conference?
Yeah, fuck the Diaz brothers, yeah?
They walked out shouting, talking.
Fuck those cockroaches!
What was it? You know what I mean? We're here ready to fight, we're ready for war.
And if you're down with Team Diaz, then fuck you two!
Let's bring it.
What's happening, my friends? Welcome to the weigh-ins. Look at this crowd. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The main event of the evening. The notorious Conor McGregor. And his opponent, important fight of your career. Give us your thoughts on this rematch.
He should have killed me when he had the chance, because now I'm back and I'm going to kill you and your whole fucking team. You and them bitch tits.
He already did from the last time. This is a new guy. So kill it, be killed again. USA, motherfuckers.
Nate Diaz, ladies and gentlemen. Connor feels like he can do better. Nate feels like he can do even better than he did in the first fight. And here we are again, 5 months later. The question is, can he make the proper adjustments to beat Nate Diaz tonight? And can Nate Diaz do it all over again?
He's confident he will. He says, I will get my redemption. Spectacular matchup.
And it's about to go down.
We are now set for our main.
Let's go. Let's go.
He didn't spar with one southpaw before the first meeting. He's done his homework in every single facet of this fight.
Now he has the opportunity to correct the mistakes he made in that first fight. We'll see if he can.
The rematch is now just moments away.
You're looking at a Nate Diaz that has had a chance to fully prepare for Conor McGregor, a full camp. And that is his exact words. He said, if I had a full camp, he wouldn't have touched me.
The world is watching again.
It's time!
Gentlemen, over the rules in the back, protect yourself at all times, obey my commands at all times. I want you to fight hard, but fight clean. If you want to touch gloves, touch now. Good luck to you both of you.
Like I said the first time, not a chance. Not a chance. McGregor. Diaz. Here we go!
Right away, he's opening up with the leg kicks. Brutal leg kicks he's landing on Nate.
Connor with a combination.
And again.
McGregor over and over.
Oh,
he knocked him.
He tagged him.
Straight left connects. Connor says, get on up. Trying to chop down the lead leg of Nate Diaz.
And tag him again. Another one. A beautiful display of leg kicking by Connor.
Diaz opens up. Final seconds of the round.
Eat
that one, Joe. 1-0 McGregor. Defiance and disdain. These men wear it like a suit of armor. Fight going according to plan thus far for McGregor. Oh, tag left.
He heard him with that.
Get back up. That's two, Joe. He's picking him apart right now. All Conor McGregor.
Oh, he heard it again.
Conor feels it.
And again with the leg kick. Nate's having a problem with that leg, Mike. He's moving on it funny. Nate putting pressure on him. He senses Connor slowing down. Nate putting pressure on him.
Rocks him. And again. Big combination.
Diaz weathered the storm, and now Conor McGregor is in trouble.
We have ourselves a fight. Pressure early.
And again with the leg kick. Beautiful counter.
Slip and rip.
Connor is fading radically here.
Nate senses it.
Nate just pointed to him and he just rocked him.
They
and
clinch.
Now he's putting pressure on him.
quick punches to the jaw.
Oh!
There's the big body shots. McGregor's in big trouble here.
Nate Diaz
going
off.
Looking to finish him right here, right now. Final seconds of the round.
Energized
here in round four.
Nate is bloodied up, Mike, real bad. Again, Nate with the clinch, drops down for the double. Can he get it? No, good defense by Connor. Very nice combination there. He seems to have caught a second win, Mike.
Wow. 5 minutes remain.
Nasty leg kick to start things off.
This fight could very well be tied at two.
Connor attempts a flying knee.
Nate just smothers it.
McGregor is stuck. Combination there by Nate. Those shots landed, as did those. Oh!
Big elbow.
And Connor turns it around. Connor with a trip, and Nate right back up to his feet. Beautiful takedown by Nate Diaz.
Wow.
What a fight.
They left it all inside the octagon.
What a fight.
For the winner by majority decision, the notorious Conor McGregor.
I'm here with the winner, Conor McGregor. Conor, that was a dogfight. You had to dig deep. Give us your thoughts.
Surprise, surprise, motherfucker. The king is back.
I heard that we heard Munsell's gonna say
no
that.
Way.
Surprise, surprise, motherfucker. The king is back.
Everyone from the media to the fighters wrote me off this one.
They all dealt me. Every one of you dealt me.
They tried to say, if I lose this one, I'm done.
Both absolute warriors, but it's Conor McGregor with the majority decision victory over Nate Diaz.
Conor just fought a smooth, smart game plan.
He proved a lot to a lot of people, including myself.
They're both winners in my book.
The energy was so crazy.
Oh my God, it was insane.
Epic fight.
So after that fight when I lost, and I'm looking at all these people and they're all celebrating my demise and saying I'm done and this, and it certainly lit a fire under my belly. Every single person doubted me. Every single fighter doubted me. Doubt me now.
Just knocked him out.
Conor McGregor is for real.
I picked the round.
Oh, unbelievable. Slept him. Man, what a fight.
Two-weight world champion. UFC history. New York. The Irish are back.